Good morning, everybody. This is Judy from Artistic Artifacts in Alexandria, Virginia, and we are ready for Shop Small. So this is a special day for those of you to come visit your favorite small business, and we hope that we are on that list, if not topping that list. If you cannot make it to the store, we do have our in-store sale, which is 23% off. And the correct code is GOOD, G-O-O-D, BUY, B-U-Y, 2023. We've had a little bit of hiccups over the weekend or over the holiday. It's now the weekend, it's Saturday. So I think I got it straight now. Remember, it's a new system, so be kind. I know it's frustrating, and thank you so much for those of you who knew us well enough to send us an email saying, you got a problem, it's not working. So I've tried to fix it, and I think we're good. I haven't had a chance to check my emails this morning, but I think I covered everybody. So in the store and online, it is 23% off. There are a few exclusions, the very obvious ones, gift certificates, workshops, the stockings, the charity drive stockings, and sewing machines, which are already more than 23% off. So we would love to see you today. We'd love to see you online. And we thank you very much for your continued support of us in what 2023 has been kind of a big pothole. So we're looking forward to saying goodbye. We're giving you goodbyes, and we hope that we inspire your creativity. So we have Kathy Lincoln here this morning talking about a Bernina foot, which is the foot of the month. So she's got jam-packed information that will hopefully inspire you to try some new things. So, Kathy.
Okay. Yes, today we are going to be going over the number 43 free motion couching foot. You can use it on your regular sewing machine, you can use it on the embroidery machine, and I'm going to show you both. And if you want more information, my ever ready great resource is the Big Book of Feet. And there are four pages of information about the foot, what it looks like, how to thread it, all the different things you can do with it, with instructions on how to do these things. I'm going to be demonstrating two out of the four things, because we don't have all day. So just remember your Big Book of Feet, pages 133 to 136, is all about the free motion couching foot. Okay. So we are going to, this is the 535, and I'm setting it up to just work on free motion work on the sewing side. And I'm going to be doing, showing you how to use it, and then how to create a quilt label, because you can make a quilt label on your regular sewing machine without having to worry about embroidery. Now, embroidery is easier, it's much more fun, but it works really well on the machines that have the larger feed dogs. Now, this one is 5.5 millimeters, so it doesn't have the larger feed dogs, but I do have an example to show you what the 9 millimeter feed dog letters look like. The 5.5 millimeter letters look just fine. They're just a little smaller, so your label will be a little smaller, and that's fine too. Is there a question?
No.
Okay.
Just reading comments.
Okay. So we're going to start. I have my machine threaded with coordinating thread. I have a ball of cotton yarn. It's sweetened sugar something. It's what you make those little wash rags out of. At least my mother did, and I do, and I make hundreds of them. Everyone gets three or four. If you knit, you know what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
Or if you've been a recipient of three or four dozen of them over your lifetime, you know exactly what they are. But it works really well. I'm using a thread tamer to help me guide this so it feeds nice and smoothly. And I have not threaded it traditionally, like a thread tamer is supposed to be threaded, because I don't want that extra drag. I just want a guide and to keep it from getting caught up and stuff. Now, on the side of your machine, and I'm going to show you on when I do the embroidery how to put on the little thread guide that goes on your thread cutter. Now, to thread the foot, you know, you have your machine all threaded. It is a straight stitch. You can only do this with a straight stitch, because if you look at the foot, you'll see that it only has this little tiny opening. No zigzagging, not even a little. Now, it does come with a wire. Is the wire still in here? I lost mine at home. It's somewhere on my floor of my studio, and I don't see it here. So there's a couple different ways of, no, that's over there. There's a couple different ways of doing this. If you have a thicker thread, you can use a thread cradle. Otherwise, you do the little, very unsanitary, put it in your mouth, and then thread it through this little hole. And then it goes down through that center hole here. So it looks like that. And then you put it on your machine. Just like you do any foot. You also need to make sure, and on the 535, I don't believe you can actually change it. You can only just, it will tell you, okay, let me get up here and show you. On the 770, whoops, that I'm going to be doing the embroidery on, you'll be able to see that it changes. The 43 foot. This is just going to tell you what it is. It's not going to actually change it on this machine. So don't panic. I have put stabilizer on the back of my fabric. This is Stable Stick. It is an adhesive stabilizer. You can use freezer paper. When we get over to the embroidery, I'll show you what everything looks like. And I'm going to show you that you can really do free motion work. So let me put my foot down. Let me put my needle down. And find my foot pedal. Here we go. Okay. I need to get my needle thread underneath here. So, it's free motion. Except for, I think I forgot to drop the feed dogs. Yes, I did. That's why it's acting kind of inky. Okay. But you can do all kinds of cool things, like you can do a leaf. And my thread just broke. Back this up to where I left off. pin needle down. Let me get that out of the way. I think I might reduce my upper tension just a little bit, and that will help my needle thread not break. So you can see you can do all kinds of things. You can do a star. You can do your loop-de-loops. And my thread broke again. Okay, we're going to move on to the quilt label. And when you make sure that if you want to keep the same thread, same yarn, you pull it out, and that way you don't have to re-thread it.
Somebody's asking about the thread breaks, and
it depends. I may have been pulling or pushing too hard. It may be operator error. You know, it does happen. So let's say I'm going to work on a border for my label. I'm going to do it right in here, and I'm going to start in this corner. Let me drop my needle. Oops, I got to put my foot down. I'm so used to my 880 that it, because when I start, it drops its foot. Okay. I'm just going, okay, let's get this out of the way. I'm just going to do a little wavy border. And since this is a 5.5 millimeter feed dog machine, I'm just going to make it a little label. And thread broke. I was moving too fast. That was me. It's not the machine. So I could finish this up. If I wanted to be really lazy, all I have to do is just tie it. And then take a very large tapestry needle and poke it through and tie it off in the back. And then I could take off my foot, put on my regular foot, and then go to my alphabets. And make sure you're in combi mode. Oops, I chose the wrong alphabet. There we go. If you're in combi mode, then you can go and you can expand this, and you can use uppercase, lowercase, and then if you need a space, you can do the underscore, then you go back to your letters. I'm going to put T. Then I'm going to go back up here to capital letters, L, lowercase, O, V, E. So that would be my first line. Let me collapse that. And then I would go here and go to complete pattern and choose it once. and then I could stitch it out. And that's and I would then I would stitch it with spaghetti, which is a heavier thread, so that it would look like this. This is what the spaghetti looks like. I would also change my needle to a larger needle. I think there's an 80 in there right now. I would probably go up to 100 because this is a 12 weight thread, and you're going to want the larger eye. And actually a top stitch needle would work really well in this case. So that is the basic couching on your regular sewing machine. We're going to now go over to the embroidery machine, and I'm going to show you a few other things. I should talk about the cording. The cording needs to be soft. It needs to be between 1.5 and 2 millimeters. So you have multiple choices. There's yarn, there is cording that's like this, there is rat tail like this. There's any number of different kinds of things that you can use. What I tell you will not use, you can't really use, is your old macrame thread. I tried. It's too stiff. It's the right size, but it's too stiff. It needs to be very, very soft and supple. Okay. Off to the embroidery machine. Now, I was going to talk about stabilizers. You can use freezer paper, old school freezer paper. That works better on the sewing machine. On the embroidery machine, I really like Aquamesh Plus or Stable Stick. They are both stabilizers that are sticky. They have adhesive on them. So they really stick to the fabric, and you put them on the fabric before you hoop it up. Oops. Trying to run away. There we go. The first thing we're going to do is we're going to do this design. It is Joy, and you'll see that I have brought everything to the back and tied it off in the back. This is the Stable Stick on the back, and it's just stuck there. It's a tearaway, so you can remove it if you choose. If I were doing this on a tote bag, I wouldn't take it out. I would actually go to my larger hoop, and I would put designs around the Joy. Now, you can get this design. It's in Designer version 9 under one of the tutorials on couching. And I'm pretty sure I haven't checked on Creator, but I'm pretty sure on Creator you would have the same tutorial. So it's a free design as long as you have the software. And that's what I have set up in the machine right now. And so let's. But the first thing I want to do is I want to show you how to put your guide on. Now this is, I'm going to put it back on here because otherwise you won't be able to see it. This is the little guide that goes on to your thread cutter. And the way to put this on, the easiest way to put it on, is to actually take your thread cutter off. And all you have to do is just pull it down and it comes off. You'll see that it just really pops out, and then what you'll do is you'll put this onto your thread cutter just like that. And then you'll put your thread cutter back up. And I just have to line it up. There we go. Far over. There we go. And it just snaps back into place. So that's a piece you can take off and put back on if your thread cutter gets dull, because they do if you sew enough, and I'm hoping you're sewing enough. you can replace that part yourself. You just come and talk to our service department, and I'm sure they have extras. And I'm sure they'll sell it to you. So now I'm going to be doing this in red. I have the machine threaded in red. I'm going to put it through the guide. And did I bring my scissors over with me? And I'm going to thread. Actually, I don't have the machine all threaded. Okay. Get that out of the way. Thread this the same way.
Can you just leave the guide on the thread cutter, or does it get in the way if you're doing other projects?
No, you can leave it on there. This, I'll take this off because this is my guide for my foot, and I want to take it home with me. But you can just leave it on. And it's actually handy even if you're not using this foot, if you're using a different foot to couch threads, because there are multiple different feet that you can use. And just leave it there, and it'll be a nice guide. Now you'll notice that I have, because we have the multi-thread spools thread stand on, I'm just using that to help me guide it from the top. Okay.
So you can embroider with a standard sewing machine? I'm not sure, Jessica.
It's not true embroidery. I mean, that 535, you could put a module on it. We just don't have a module set up with it.
But you were doing an alphabet on that machine.
That's in the machine built in.
Yes.
So that's not technically embroidery, but it's... the next
it's
best
stitch.
Thing.
It's a
it's design.
Decorative stitching.
Yeah.
And does the same thread guide work on the Q20?
Yes. And on the Q20, you actually have that extra thread stand, because you have two places for thread. You would just put the whatever you're using through that extra guide. Now, you'll notice that this, because it's a ball of yarn, is not going to go onto a thread stand. Mm-hmm. I have my handy dandy Tupper container. And I'm gonna let a bunch of it out just to be.
Now, is that made by Bernina too?
Oh, the Tupper. No, that came out of my little crazy cabinet that has all kinds of stuff in it. So I'm just going to throw that back there. I'm going to get this set up because I already have this hooped. Let it do its shimmy. And once again, I have stable stick on the back. Make sure that I don't have anything caught in the wrong direction. And yes, okay. Oh, and make sure you slow down your machine. Thank you. needle thread caught there, but I can fish that out. Once again, make sure that you don't cut this too short. I need to leave it a little longer so I can feed it through, and I can pull my needle thread and get it out of the way here. Just trim it up. But anyhow, that is doing one way of embroidering. Oh, I cut it on the wrong side, so I have to re-thread it. But anyhow, that's not a problem. I also want to show that in the machine, you have built-in design. And I'm going to go back up here. I'm going to go back to the machine. Built-in designs. You have built-in pantographs on your machine. And you also can buy pantographs, but there are built-in. And I'm going to choose, that's...
So you could take the same technique and use one of these designs?
Yes. I have to find, let's see, where is... What you want to do is you want to have a single design, not a triple. And I think, let's see, because I have it on my 700, let's, okay. And this is saying it's in the small clamp. I have the large clamp. Let me show you what I did on.
And real quick, could you explain the difference between the design? You said the double, not a triple.
Oh, you don't want to do a triple stitch where it's going back and forth. You want to do a single stitch. Because there are pantograph designs that are both single stitch and triple stitch. If you were doing it without the yarn, you would probably want the triple stitch, because then it would show more. It'd be more dramatic. But because you're working with the yarn, you really don't want that back and forth. And this is the one I was looking for, but it's not on the 770, it's on my 700. But it's a pantograph, and you have these in your machine. Let me go back up here, and you can see these are designs that are meant to be run together. It has a beginning, it has an end, and then this next one has where the end would match or the beginning will match the end of this one, and it'll keep on going. Then you have corner pieces. You have, this could be a very nice one for that would work for around a quilt label. And these, I think these are singles. These are also pantographs. And look at all the fun stuff you have in here. Lots and lots of fun stuff. Actually, I like this one better. Let's go with this guy.
And we have these machines available?
Yes.
As part of the Black Friday sale.
Yes, we do. So even though this says it's going to be in the medium hoop, I'm going to tell it that I want to use the medium clamp. Let's see. Here we go. Clamp medium. So I have the correct hoop selected. I have the correct foot selected. I'm going to close out of here. And now, this is only going to, I'm going to make sure the machine is slowed down. You want to make sure your machine is really slowed down. Yeah. And I'm going to put this on. Now, if I wanted to, I could connect two of these together. Let me show you how I do that. I may not stitch it all out. Let me go here. And let me do a duplicate. And then on the second one, I am going to mirror image it right, left, up, down. There we go. I'm going to grab the first one and I'm going to move it up and over just a little bit. And this one I'm going to grab down and over a little bit. So if I want to fill in a quilt block, and I'm going to go to my magnifier and make sure that I have them really lined up. Oops, I forgot I got to go here. There we go. Is there a question?
Yes. So
okay.
If you were to take like the joy design you did earlier, could you, how would you adapt that to a garment?
I could easily put on the back of a garment. I could put it on, because it's small enough, I could probably put it on one side of a sweater. It would go great on a tote bag. And then you'd want to use the free arm hoop.
Yeah, that's the same question that Jessica had, is to do a sweatshirt, you use that free arm hoop.
You could easily use that, yes.
Yes, because it fits right over the
hoop. Right, because you have this free arm. Every one of these machines has a free arm. So that you would slide, you would hoop up the front of whatever you're working on, and then slide the back underneath, and then that would work.
And that's a special hoop we have.
Right.
Yeah.
So I'm going to put that back there.
And the accessories are included in the 23% off sale.
So, I need to close this. So now you can see. So this would fill in a quilt block quite nicely.
Cool.
And if you wanted to, you could have two more going the opposite direction. But we're not going to do that today. So I have it all hooped up. I just have to re-thread my, rethread my foot because I cut it on the wrong side. So now I've got to get it to where it wants to be. Grab switch hoops here. Now this one's a little more of a challenge to get on over this big foot, but as you see, you can do it. Stop it and cut this so I don't have to dig it out. You get to play with this foot. You have multiple options. The hardest part is finding the right cording. You may have to do a little exploring. This cotton yarn works really well, but there's many other different options. And are there questions?
Just as a refresher, what's the foot that you're using today?
It's a number 43 free motion couching foot.
Yep, that's it. Everything else is.
How are we doing time wise?
Oh, we gotta open this one.
Oh, okay. Okay, I'm just gonna let this run and then I'm gonna leave it in the shop. So if you're local, you can come in and see what it looks like when it's finished. And Chris will post pictures when it's done.
Links that we talked about.
Yeah, with all the links. And remember, if you're online and you're working on the website, it's goodbye 2023. And bye is B-U-Y. So have a great rest of your holiday weekend. And so, because you don't have to cook because you have leftovers.